It was once a massive forest lying less than 10 kilometers north of the Atlantic Ocean, enslaved by same depravities that have plagued humankind globally.
Strange diseases,
defiling medical interventions,
occultism in high dimensions,
dishonesty,
wickedness, and more to mention.
But a single look,
a look to the author and finisher, signals the authority.
It's a power shift,
power from on high upon your life.
You've never seen anything like this before.
The day when everything that is dead, dormant, dull in your life will rise up.
July 28th to August 2nd, 2022, 1600 hours GMT daily and 0700 hours GMT Sunday worship service packaged on a global scale for all.
Men, women, ministers and professionals, children, youth and young adults.
A total package by the convener, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, at the GCK July edition, live at Ikorodu, Lagos State, Nigeria.
Poised to reveal total emancipation by the authority of Christ.
The inspirational and international evangelist, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi,
will be ministering along with Jeff Dio, our guest music minister.
Coming to you live from Ikorodu, Lagos State, Southwest Nigeria.
And broadcast to the world via satellite, social media,
radio and television.
We are inviting the entire populace in and around Lagos. PFL Lagos is fully involved, and our men and women and youth have been charged, have been given the marching order to ensure that this thing is a huge success. We are praying, we are believing, we are putting the network and our resources into it. And we trust at the end of it all, millions of souls will be gladly brought into the kingdom of God.
GCK, in the seventh month, globally packaged to perfect total emancipation by the authority of Jesus Christ.
Get ready for total freedom.
This July,
I'm going to grab you by the hand, drag you out of the valley, and I'm going to drag you to the mountaintop.
The Global Crusade with Kumuyi, GCK Authority, is coming.
The Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you all in Jesus' name. I want to welcome you all again, once again tonight, for the final day of this global crusade, total emancipation through the authority of Christ. We thank the Lord for what the Lord has been doing for us and how the Lord has been blessing each and every one of us. Tonight, get ready you will also be blessed in a mighty way in Jesus' name. Shall we close our eyes as we go to the Lord in prayers? I want you to thank the Lord for giving you this opportunity once again to be part of this program. Shall we open our mouth and lift up our voices to the Lord and worship the Lord, our Father in heaven, who has been so good unto us, so gracious to us, doing wonderful things in our lives, giving us this privilege, the opportunity to come together with the people of God to seek His face and to be blessed by His word this evening. Shall we open our mouth and worship the name of the Lord and say, Father, we thank you. Father, we lift too high. You are worthy to be praised. Blessed be to your holy name for your mercies, for your favor, for your kindness upon us. We are grateful unto you. We love you so much, Lord, because it's been you who has been doing great, marvelous, and wonderful things in our lives. Let's lift up Jesus tonight. Let's give glory unto him and say, Father, we thank you. We appreciate you so much, Lord. We bless you for your faithfulness upon us, for the wonderful things you have been doing for us. Shall we open our mouth and thank the Lord for the past 6 days that this program has started. Today is the final day of this global crusade all over the world. And tonight, we're going to experience a touch, the blessings of God upon our lives. Let's open our mouth and say, Father, we thank you. Father, we worship your name. Father, we lift you high. We honor you. We give glory to you because you're worthy to be praised. Blessed be to your holy name. Let's thank him. Let's honor him. Let's give glory to the Lord tonight and say, Father, we thank you. We appreciate you. To you be the glory, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Bible says, hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. As we have come this evening to renew our strength before the Lord, we're waiting upon the Lord. We're waiting in his presence. We have come to see him tonight. You want to pray and tell the Lord and say, Father, I want you to renew my strength tonight in Jesus' name. You are not a weary God. You are not God who fails. I come to you tonight. I want you to touch me. I want you to bless me in a mighty way tonight. In the name of Jesus, shall we open our mouth and pray and commit ourselves into the hands of the Lord? Open your mouth and pray. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Ask the Lord to renew your strength tonight, even as you have come before him in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask him to renew your strength, to touch you tonight in the name of Jesus. He will bless you in a mighty way. Shall we open our mouth and pray and say, Father, I come to your presence tonight. Renew my strength in the name of Jesus Christ. Take away every weakness, every weariness. Sometimes our mind is weakened. Sometimes our physical strength is weakened. You want to pray and tell the Lord and say, Father, renew my strength tonight. Every weakness, spiritually, physically, mentally, that makes me to look so weak, as if there is no future, as if there is no hope. Oh Lord, revive me from the inner man in the name of Jesus and lift me up from tonight. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord and say, Father, I come to your presence for a renewal, for transformation, for transformation. Oh Lord, and begin to transfer me from the point of weakness to the point of strength, where you are, the place of perfection, the place of power, the place where your spirit, your presence resides. Oh Lord, transform me into the place of strength tonight. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord, you have known tonight, you have heard that God, the everlasting God, fainteth not, is not weary, he giveth strength to the weak. And those who have no might, increaseth strength. Tonight, God will increase your strength in Jesus' name. Why not you pray and tell the Lord and say, Father, I come for strength. I need you in my life. I want you to take hold of me. Lift me up out of the dungeon of despondency, out of the place of powerlessness, the place of retrogression and dejection and discouragement. Lift me up from tonight in the name of Jesus Christ to the place of strength, of progress, of marching on, of moving on, of marching forward in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord, Lord, lift me up. From tonight, begin to lift me up into your power, into your presence. Begin to lift me up, O Lord, into your grace in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord, you are presenting yourself before the Lord. You are presenting your family members, your children, your husband, your wife. We are presenting ourselves before the Lord and say, Lord, begin to visit us. In this family, in this church, in our homes, visit my husband, visit my wife, visit my children. You are talking about yourself. You are presenting your family members, your loved ones into the hands of the Lord and say, Father, I come to you tonight. Bless me in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord tonight and say, Father, I come to you. Renew my strength tonight in the name of Jesus and lift me up. And make me to be able to dwell in the place of your perfection, the place of strength where you have destined me to be and to be. Every retrogressive spirit, every setback and limitation, every spirit that wants to make me to be dejected, discouraged, I destroy their plans against my life tonight in Jesus' name. Pray and tell the Lord, this is the hour of prayer. So you've got to pray. You've got to call upon the name of the Lord. You've got to ask him to touch you tonight. You've got to ask him to lift you up and remove all the distractions from the pit of hell and remove all the plans of the wicked ones against your life and cover you in his blood tonight in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord and say, Father, everything that makes me to be discouraged about your world, about heaven, about making progress in life, tonight, in the name of Jesus, I cancel them in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I come to you. I need a renewed strength in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask for a renewed strength in the name of Jesus. Lord, renew my strength. Lord, lift me up in the name of Jesus and touch my life and transform me in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and pray and begin to commit yourself into the hands of the Lord. We are in the presence of the Lord. We have come to renew our strength. We have come to be lifted up. We have come to be transformed. We have come to be honored by God. Open your mouth and pray and tell the Lord. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to your presence tonight. Honor me, O Lord. Bless me, O Lord. Lift me up, O Lord, and do great and mighty things in my life, even tonight in Jesus' name. As I participate in this global crusade, my life will be renewed. My life will be touched. No more downcasted in the name of Jesus Christ. Now I'm elevated. I'm lifted up. I'm moving forward. I am emancipated from dejection and setback and limitations into the place of progress and power in Christ Jesus. Do it in my life tonight in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's pray together. Father, as we have come to your presence tonight, we are asking that your spirit, your power, your glory will overshadow us in Jesus' name. Fill us to overflowing tonight. That Lord, tonight you will bless us all, even as we have come to your presence in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, because we know you have answered our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you all. Every one of us online tonight, I can see you all. God bless you all. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. Today is the final day of this global crusade. We started last week Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and today is the final day. So we thank God for what the Lord has done for us and what the Lord is doing for us and what the Lord will do in our lives tonight in Jesus' name. So I want you to get ready. Prepare yourself. Don't allow anything to distract you, and you'll be blessed tonight in Jesus' name. We'll be singing tonight from our hymn book. It says, I must tell Jesus. You see, everything, the burdens of your heart, you've got to present them to Jesus. It says, I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone. in my distress. He kindly will help me. He ever loves and cares for his own. I must tell Jesus all of my troubles. He is a kind, compassionate friend. If I but ask him, he will deliver. Make of my troubles quickly an end. Tempted and tried, I need a great Savior, one who can help my burdens to bear. I must tell Jesus, he all my cares and sorrows will share. Oh, how the world to evil allures me. Oh, how my heart is tempted to sin. I must tell Jesus, and he will help me over the world and the victory to win. I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear my burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, Jesus can help me. Jesus alone, Jesus can help you. He can help every one of us, and him alone can do great and marvelous things in our lives, and he will help you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all.
I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, behold my kiss and sorrows will share.
To tell Jesus, he can help you, and he alone has the power to lift you up tonight, and he will in Jesus' name. Whatever the burdens may be, whatever the trials may be, rely upon Jesus. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. And so if we believe in him tonight, he will lift us up, he will help us, and he will help us, he will deliver us. God bless you all in Jesus' name. We want to listen to our gospel music minister tonight, Jeff Dale, before our Father and the Lord comes up to minister to us as the Lord has prepared him to bless us in a mighty way tonight. Get ready. Blessings are coming your way tonight in Jesus' name.
Good evening and welcome to the final evening together for this global crusade. We are so blessed and humbled and honored to be here together with Dr. Pastor Kumi, and we give all praise and honor to our glorious God. Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Stand with us if you would, and we will worship the Lord and believe for total emancipation by the authority of Christ. Come on, clap your hands.
The God who is, we worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors, he parted the raging sea. My God, he holds the victory.
Sing, hey!
My God in the house of the Lord, we're sure in the house of the Lord. Saves. We sing to the God who always makes a way.
papa, eshe o papa, awa du pe papa, papa papa papa, eshe o papa, eshe o papa, awa du pe papa. Come on, lift your voice, papa, eshe o papa. Come on, eshe o papa. Awa dupe papa, ba 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 ba. Eshe o papa, eshe o papa. Awa dupe papa.
Faithful, and all my time. All my life you have been faithful. Declare that. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing, and I will sing of the goodness one time of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
God has been so faithful. All our lives, God has been so faithful. And therefore, we will sing of the goodness of God in our lives. I'm sure God is faithful to you too. He's been faithful to me. What about you? He's been faithful to you. To God be the glory in Jesus' name. Tonight, welcome to this final day of this global crusade. As I welcome our Father and the Lord, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi. And tonight, get ready. The Lord has prepared him to bless us tonight. So I don't want you to look away from this tonight. I don't want you to be distracted. I want you to stay focused and be blessed tonight. And God will bless you abundantly in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. If you have your hands there, praise the Lord. What I hear looks like a local village, community, local government clapping. I want a global clapping. Praise the Lord. You will shout tonight. You will sing tonight. You will testify tonight of the goodness of God. Throughout this crusade, as in all of our lives, we have found him to be faithful and to be so, so good. And tonight, being the last night, every debris that still remains there, every affliction that still remains there, yoke, infirmity, sickness, any property of the devil, the broom of heaven will sweep everything out of your life. Tonight, after the final amen, please, don't go away. Don't rush away. We must hear what God will do tonight in your life. Don't say, I'll go back home, I'll share the testimony in my local church. That's good. But that local church, the people there were just here. I want to show your face to the world. That you are a partaker. That you are a receiver of the miracle power of God. Amen. Where's your face? I can't even see it very well. Anyway, after the meeting, you'll come here. I, with my two eyeballs, I will see your face. Because you will discover whatever problem you brought tonight, you'll find out nothing is impossible with God. You will do your own. I said you will do your own. What are you? Raise up that hand. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I come tonight representing you and saying nothing shall be impossible in any life. And tonight, I pray you will open the heavens. power, anointing, authority, unction will come down in a mighty, unforgettable way in Jesus' name. Show your love. Show your mercy. Show your grace. Show your power in every life tonight. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Tonight, you can sit down. God bless you. Sit down in the blessing of the Lord. Tonight, we're wrapping up everything about emancipation. Total emancipation. All round emancipation. Assured emancipation. Present emancipation. Progressing emancipation. And permanent emancipation in your life. But I need to show you, if you want to go and buy something at the groceries and the market, you need to know the way and the path that leads there. For you to have permanent, perfect, great, total, all-round emancipation, I need to show you the path that leads there. Especially as we're finishing tonight, the message is the path of total emancipation with triumphant Emmanuel. Emancipation from Emmanuel, total from him that is triumphant. The path of total emancipation with triumphant Emmanuel. Understand, I didn't say from. Yes, it comes from him. I didn't say through. Yes, it's through him emancipation comes. I use the word with. That when you are close, working with him, and you are connected with him, and you are not separated from him, and you are with him all the time. At home, emancipation. At work, emancipation. In the market, emancipation. Anywhere you go, everywhere you find yourself, with Emmanuel. Total, perfect, permanent emancipation in your life. Look at this. Luke chapter 3. And I'm reading from verse 4. As it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah, the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. The path that gets to him, make his path straight. The way, the road, the express way that we take. Take all the bumps, all the pitfalls, take everything away. Make his path straight. That is what John the Baptist came to do. As Christ was to come, he had to make the path straight so that the people will know the way, they will see the road, and then there'll be no bumps there, there'll be no pit holes there. They go straight to the Lord. What I come to do tonight is to declare to you the pathway, is to declare to you the road, is to declare to you the expressway that leads to Emmanuel. And once you get to him, emancipation is sure. Look at verse 5. It says in verse 5, every valley shall be filled, every mountain and hill shall be brought low. Why? Because if the mountain is there, your path will not be straight and smooth to get to him. But all the mountains are taken away. All the hills are taken away. All the hills are leveled so that everyone can now come. No hindrance in your way. No obstruction in your way. The sinner will walk through that path and get salvation. The sick will walk through that path and get healing. The depressed and the oppressed and the demonized will come and get deliverance. And everyone having any need, you will come. The road will be so clear. The path will be so plain that tonight nothing shall be impossible. Let me hear the Alpha location. Amen. And then it says, the rough ways shall be made smooth. What else do we need? That as we are coming to God, there'll be no hold up. There'll be no go slow. There'll be no obstruction. There will be no up and down. The way will be made smooth. So, if everything is done, if the mountains are removed, if the hills are removed, if the way is made clear, if anyone does not come, you cannot blame anybody. Because now God says, for you, in particular, it will make the way so smooth, you will come, you will receive. Amen. Miracle. Amen. Salvation. Amen. Healing. Deliverance, liberation, and total and permanent and perfect emancipation the Lord will give to you even tonight in Jesus' name. When the way is clear, when the road is clear, and when the pathway of the Lord leading from where you are to where you ought to be with faith, and with grace, and with the mercy of God, and with the love of God, you come to the Lord and you receive. You will receive in Jesus' name. Because of his love, and because of his power, and because with him, all things. Somebody help me shout, all things. Everything we need. All the miracle we need, all the things that he himself has prepared for us, he says, tonight, the path to get there, the way to get there, and the road to get there, that tonight, as I give you the instruction, and I show you the way, you will take that way. I will take that way. Say it aloud. And by the grace of God, in the strength of the Lord, by the provision of the Lord, everything will be yours. And then look at verse 6 there. In verse 6 there it says, and all people, everyone, shall see the salvation of the Lord. Tonight, you see the salvation of the Lord. There's forgiveness in that salvation. There is freedom in that salvation. There is authority and power in that salvation. There is joy and happiness in that salvation. There is answer to prayer in that salvation. You will have the salvation of the Lord. Full. Complete. The Lord will grant to you tonight in Jesus' name. Once again, the path of total emancipation with triumphant Emmanuel. He's Emmanuel, and the meaning of Emmanuel is God with us. He will be with you. The Creator God with us. The Redeemer God with us. The All-Powerful, the Most High God with us. And because he's Emmanuel, is triumphant, because he is Emmanuel, is victorious, because he's Emmanuel, he conquers every problem that you have. And tonight, with him, Emmanuel, with him, Creator, with him, Redeemer, with him, the solution to every problem of life, your way now is clear. Emancipation, liberation, salvation, healing, deliverance, breaking of yoke, and everything available. The Lord will do it in your life in Jesus' name. And all flesh, all people, all men here, all. Are you there? All. Are you there? Are you part of this? And all flesh shall see. I will see. I will see. My brother, there you will see. My sister, there you will see. And all flesh shall see the salvation. That's an all-encompassing word. Salvation for the soul and for the body and for the mind. Salvation includes forgiveness, freedom, healing, deliverance, miracle, joy, provision, everything. And you will see the salvation of God. Amen. You know, I put strength into my amen so that any force of darkness will know when I say amen, I really mean it. And tonight, in the name of the Lord, you will see the salvation of God. There are three things we're looking at in the message tonight. Number one, immediate emancipation. Number two, irreversible emancipation. A kind of freedom, a kind of liberty, a kind of deliverance, a kind of redemption that is irreversible. That when God, the God of heaven, when he does that in your life, nothing will take it away. Irreversible. Salvation tonight, irreversible. Healing tonight, irreversible. The power of God coming upon your life tonight, irreversible. Number two, irreversible emancipation. Number three, interminable emancipation. That nothing can halt it. Nothing can shut it up. Nothing can terminate it. Nothing can reduce it to an absolute nothing, that, you know, people go back to where they were before. Interminable. Number one, immediate emancipation through faith in Christ. Number two, irreversible emancipation through fellowship and constancy. Fellowship and constancy. Number three, interminable emancipation through faithfulness as conquerors. You'll be a conqueror. I will be a conqueror. And the spirit that conquers and the spirit that overcomes, overcomes every challenge in your life. That spirit, that courage, that mind, that ability and possibility, it will give to you tonight in Jesus' name. Immediate, irreversible, interminable. Number one, immediate emancipation through faith in Christ. Look at Galatians chapter 1, reading from verse 15. But when it pleased God, who separated me from my mother's womb and called me by his grace, that Saul, who became Paul, he knew the moment of time when the call of God came unto him. And he said, it pleased God that of all people, me, an injurious man, me, a sinful man, me, a murderer, me, an evil man, yet it pleased God that is the one that separated me from my mother's womb, but now he called me by his grace, not by my good works, he had none, not by my love, he had none, not by his serving the Lord faithfully. He had none. That's why he said the call to repentance, and the call to salvation, and the call to the goodness of God is by grace. Tonight, as the road, the path, the way is made clear, and for you to travel on that road and come to the salvation of the Lord, not by the works you have done. Rock of ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from the wounded river's side which flowed be your sin, the double kill. Is the one that does it. Could my tears forever flow, and my zeal no respite know? All that, all this cannot save. Thou, and thou alone, must save. When I appear before the judgment throne, and see thee on thy throne, Rock of ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. It is by the grace of God. And as the way is made clear tonight, and you come, salvation will be yours. Immediate salvation, immediate forgiveness, immediate freedom and joy of salvation in your life. Look at verse 16 there. In verse 15 it said, to reveal a son in me, that I might preach him among the heathen. Look at the word again. Immediately, I conferred not with flesh and blood. I made up my mind. Grace is available for me. The way is made clear. And because the way is made clear, and he's calling me, he's calling you tonight. I said he's calling you tonight. Anywhere you are, here on the grounds, and there online, the call of God is coming to you. And what Saul did that changed him, that transformed him, and made him part of all the people, all flesh, that will see the salvation of the Lord, is that immediately he conferred not with flesh and blood, he handed over himself unto the Lord. That's how salvation comes. That's how healing comes. Immediately. Healing. Your healing tonight, instantaneous. Your healing tonight, immediate. Look at Matthew chapter 20. I'm reading from verse 32 there. Matthew chapter 20, verse 32. And Jesus stood still and called them. Called them. To salvation, called us. To healing, called us. And when Jesus stands still and calls, it means he wants to do something in your life. Where are you? He'll do something tonight. He's calling you. And he's calling you to an immediate emancipation. Look at that again. And then he said, what will you that I shall do unto you? Look at verse 33. In verse 33, they say unto him, Lord, that our eyes which are blind, our eyes dim, our eyes that see nothing. Christ says, yes, of course. And then you come immediately. And when you come and get to him, it's asking you, what do you want me to do for you? And with your mouth, you tell him, you ask him. They said that our eyes may be opened. Look at verse 34. It says, so Jesus had compassion on them. Tonight, there's compassion on you. Amen. Mercy on you. Amen. What's compassion? The Lord looks at your suffering. He looks at your sickness. He looks at your infirmity. He looks at the burden and the load upon your life. He looks at the distress of your life because of your condition, your physical condition, your moral condition, your family condition, your financial condition, the poverty, penury. He looks at everything and he has compassion, and he touched their eyes. Look at the word we're looking for. And immediately, somebody shout immediately. Immediately, their eyes received sight and they followed him. They wanted to be with him and stay with him and dwell with him and walk with him. That is how to keep your emancipation, so that the word of God with the wonder of God will be permanent and irreversible in your life. Number one is immediate emancipation. Look at number two here. Number two, irreversible emancipation through fellowship and constancy. When you abide in the Lord, when you stay with the Lord, and when you say, "He saved me, I'm going to stay with him. He healed me, I'm going to hide myself in him. He delivered me, I'm going to dwell with him." It is that brings irreversible emancipation through fellowship and constantly abiding in the Lord. Abide with me. Night falls and darkness comes, and it is only as you abide with me and I abide in you that the emancipation, the miracle we receive here, will be permanent in your life. If you abide in me and my word abides in you, if you abide in me, constancy, and my word abides in you, constancy, then you shall ask what you will and it will be done for you. Amen. Amen. Acts of the Apostles, I'm reading from chapter 2, reading from verse 41. Look at this. Then they that gladly received his word. You know what that means? When they have the word, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus, they accepted, they were happy about it. They said, "We've been waiting for somebody to tell us the way and to show us the path to get to that peace of mind and the salvation of the Lord." And so when they heard, it says, they heard gladly and received the word gladly. They were baptized, and the same day they were added unto them about 3,000 souls. Added unto them. Added to the believers that had believed before them. That's why when you give your life to the Lord, you don't go back home and just stay at home, and you don't go back to idols. You come to the church. I don't mean this church or that church. You come to the church. Any church exalting Christ. Any church teaching us the Bible. Any church telling us that Jesus is the way, the only way. Whatever the name of that denomination, the church that honors Christ, leads up Christ, and points us to Christ, that he is the all in all in our lives. Look at verse 42. In verse 42, and he continues steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship. Fellowship. And in breaking of bread and in prayers. You know, as you come to the Lord, if you have not come, tonight you will come. Amen. And as you come, peace of mind. Amen. Joy of the Lord. Salvation of the Lord. Healing from the Lord. Deliverance from the Lord. Emancipation from the Lord. And then it says they continued in fellowship. And it continued in the apostles' doctrine. Look at verse 43. It says, "And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders." Many wonders. That's what many. As many as how? As many as the people who are there.
I didn't hear you. Many wonders. You will get your own. You will get your own. On the choir side there, everyone to the back, you will get your own. Many, many, many wonders. Even me, I will get my wonder. And our ministers, they'll get their wonders. Everyone on my side over here, you will get your wonders. Many, many wonder for your father, wonder for your mother, wonder for your brother, wonder for your sister, wonder for everyone. You will have something to talk about this week, this month, this year. You will have the wonders of the Lord, wonders of the cross, wonders of recreation, wonders of emancipation, and the wonders of the goodness of God in your life, in Jesus' name. You won't say, I wonder I was there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days I was there, but I don't have anything. Nobody will talk like that. The wonder of the Lord, and the wonder of life, and the wonder of provision, and the wonder of his unction and anointing, and the wonder of his miracle you will have in your life in Jesus' name. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles, by not just one apostle, apostle 2, 3, 4, 10, 12, and how many they are, by the apostles. Anointing will work in your life. Anointing that breaks every yoke will work in your life. Miracles, deliverances, healings, total freedom. Look at Acts chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 12. Acts chapter 5. We're looking at verse 12. And by the hands of the apostles were many. Look at that again. Many. Look at not just one person. My eyes are open. Praise the Lord for one. Then I about two. I about three. I about ten. I about all the people there. Not just one. My deaf ears were open. And my deaf tongue started talking. One. Praise God for one. But two and three and four and many. I was lame. Now I'm rising up and walking. Thank God for one. Thank God for two. But we thank God not just for one and two, but for many. It will come upon your life. And it says, and by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, and they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. Look at verse 14. In verse 14, it tells us, and the believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes, both men and women. And then in verse 15, it says, in so much that they brought forth the sick into the streets, into the open, and laid them on beds and couches, that at the least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. It came to the point that they were not only waiting out for preaching and for praying, as the apostle Peter was walking by, and the shadow fell on them, they were healed. I said they were healed. Now, already we have heard in chapter 3, the voice of Peter healed them. Also, we'll see in chapter 9, the touch of Peter healed the man, touched him and said, rise up in the name of Jesus. His voice, his touch, his preaching, his prayer, what miracles, and now the shadow. The shadow also worked miracles. If miracles just happen like that, I bought you tonight. You will catch your miracle. And the shadow of Peter passing by over some of them. In verse 16, it says in verse 16, and there came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed. Tell me. And they were healed. Everyone. Everyone. What does everyone mean? Means you. Everyone. I said, what does it mean? Means you. It means you are a partaker tonight, and that miracle you receive will be constant, will be irreversible. Look at John chapter 8. In John chapter 8, reading from verse 31, then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, if ye continue, if ye continue, hold on. Do you know why? It's very difficult when you make a decision. For example, you say something very simple. I'm going to be doing exercise every day because I want to keep my body firm and keep my body the proper weight to my height so that I remain strong and healthy. Do you know why you do it for one day or 2 days and then you don't continue? Because you are doing it alone. And anything you're doing on alone, you don't generally continue very well. Do you understand why students who stay at home and they say, I'm going to pass that exam all alone by themselves? Do you know why it's difficult for them to continue in their timetable and the schedule of study? All alone, difficult. But when you come to a class and you continue with that class, and as a teacher, a mentor, a trainer, a coach that is showing you the way because you are in that class of other people doing the same thing. That's how we continue. That's the reason why believers are here, other believers are there, and you join yourself to those believers so that you're not just saying, my emancipation will continue, my salvation will continue, everything I've got will continue. It's as you come to the team. The team, the team. What does that mean? Team, T-E-A-M. Together, everybody makes movement. And we move upward and we achieve because we are in the team. And you join other people. And Jesus said, make it easy for yourself to continue. Don't stay in isolation somewhere. Join the church. If ye continue in my word, then ye are ye my disciples indeed. Look at verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Somebody said there, Pastor, tell me again, I want to write that word. Team. Okay, I'll put it properly now. Together, everybody achieves more. Are you writing? You know, I'm a teacher too. Now, together, everybody achieves more. And as you come and you join other people, and you are with other people, and you are together with them in fellowship and constancy, you will be able, by the grace of God, to continue. Your miracle will be irreversible. Your deliverance will be irreversible. And every good thing you have got, emancipation, at this time, what you've got before, what you get today, it will be irreversible in your life, in Jesus' name. Number one, immediate. Number two, irreversible. Number three, interminable emancipation through faithfulness and as cockerels. You'll be a conqueror. I said you'll be a conqueror. And we have emancipation that is interminable. You get born again, you get saved, you give your life to the Lord. 1 week, you continue. 1 month, you continue. 1 year, you continue. 2 years, 3 years, until Christ will come. Interminable. The devil will not terminate your emancipation. Sickness will not terminate your emancipation. The world will not terminate your emancipation. Healing, permanent. Freedom, permanent. Salvation, permanent. Deliverance, permanent. All the grace and the gift of heaven that heaven gives you today, permanent in your life, in Jesus' name. And then, as you are walking and walking, it will come to the time when your mansion is finished over there, because the Lord will not take you from here until he has finished your mansion. He will not say, I wasn't expecting you. You left the world without giving notice. Okay, go stay here in a borrowed mansion. You'll not be in a borrowed mansion in heaven. Your own mansion. Your own room over there. I pray that you will continue. The grace of God, the goodness of God, the power of God will continue in your life. You'll be a conqueror every day, an achiever every day, an overcomer every day, a victor every day. The amen is dying down. Any brother Victor over there? Brother, I mean brother, real brother Victor. Where are you? That victory will be permanent. Any sister Victoria over there? Amen. Your voices are louder than the brother Victor's. Your victory, your triumph, your emancipation will be permanent in Jesus' name. Look at Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Romans chapter 8, we're looking at verse 37. Nay, in all these things, as we are going back home after the crusade, don't go yet. In all these things, in the classroom, in the market, in the office, on the street, in your house, in your village, in your town, in your city, with your friends, and if enemies around, among the enemies everywhere, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. You are more than a conqueror through him that loved us. He loves you. He loves me. He loves all of us. That's why he's calling us and he's telling us, salvation is for everyone. All flesh shall see his salvation, his emancipation, his healing, his deliverance, and his freedom. And it is for you tonight. And as you get it tonight, it will be permanent in your life. Joy will be permanent. Salvation, permanent. Emancipation, permanent. Liberation, permanent. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. He wants to give you that power that conquers And anywhere you go, and you carry that power on, the interminable emancipation of the Lord, as you keep on following him, one day at a time, you'll be a permanent conqueror in Jesus' name. Have I spoken to anybody there tonight? Any brother there? Any sister there? I want to assure you, all the prophecies that were uttered all these 6 days, they'll be fulfilled in your life. All the promises that were announced and that were declared, everything is on your head. And this provision of total emancipation, all around emancipation, present emancipation, permanent emancipation, everything fulfilled on your life. Sit down for a moment, sit down for a moment, sit down for a moment. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. The Lord is calling you now. You have to have a starting point, a commencement point. And he's calling you now and he's saying, God is ready for you. Christ, the Savior, is ready for you. And as you are giving your life to Christ tonight, immediately, without conferring with flesh and blood, and you say, yes, Lord, I come. I hand over my life, sinful life, poor life, depreciated life, shameful life, deficient life. I hand over my life unto you today. Lord, take me as I am. The Lord will receive you. I said the Lord will receive you. And if you're coming to the Lord now, you're saying, Lord, here I am. I've had it before. I didn't give myself, but now I give myself to Christ. I want forgiveness. I want freedom. I want salvation. Anywhere you are, raise up that hand. On the radio, raise up your hand. You can see you there. Over the television there, raise up your hand. You can see you there. Online, anywhere you are, raise up that hand. He's right there. He will save you. As you are raising up your hand, please stand up so we can identify you. And you identify yourself from the crowd. Stand up there. Thank you, brother there. Thank you, sister there. Thank you, boy. Thank you, girl. The Lord has seen it now. Today will mark a turning point in your life in Jesus' name. Keep on standing. Keep on standing. I'm praying with you now. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you, Lord, for this day and this moment of emancipation, freedom, salvation. And you said, all flesh, all men and women, all boys and girls shall see the salvation of God. I pray all these who have raised up their hands and who are standing and they're not ashamed and they want Jesus the Savior to save them, save them now in Jesus' name. Set them free. Forgive them. Turn their lives around for the better. And I pray this immediate salvation, immediate emancipation will become irreversible emancipation. Will become interminable emancipation. Let the joy of salvation come to them. And the freedom of salvation come to them. And let the strength and the grace and the power to live in newness of life come to everyone right now. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. It is done. I said it is done. Keep on standing. Our counselors are there. They will attend to you, and they will give you the slip to feel. Emancipation has happened, and you're going to carry that salvation throughout your life. Your life will know victory everywhere you go. I call on moderating pastor tonight to lead us in this time of counsel. Then I'll come back and give you the final prayer that will wrap up everything, and something great is coming your way.
Amen. Emancipation tonight, the Lord has delivered you. If you have given your life to Christ, glory be to God. I want you to just indicate, let's know about it, that you have found a new faith in Christ Jesus, so that we can further help you spiritually. And the Lord will be with you in Jesus' name. So tonight, why not you begin to commit yourself into the hands of the Lord? The man of God is coming again to pray for us tonight. This is Global Crusade. Today is a final day. Don't miss this miracle in your life tonight. Why not you begin to pray, commit yourself into the hands of the Lord? Others are praying. They are committing themselves to Christ. Begin to pray. Pray for yourself. Present them before the Lord. Life, the Lord will tonight, if you pray, commit yourself. Pray, commit yourself into the hands of the Lord and ask the Lord to touch you tonight. Ask Him to visit you tonight. Those long-standing problems, the Lord want to roll them away. Pray about them tonight. Pray for yourself. You want God to keep you safe? Pray. You want God to protect you? Pray. You want God to deliver you? Pray. You want God to heal you? Pray. There is power in the word of God. Open your mouth and pray. Are you concerned about somebody? A family member? Maybe it's your son, your husband, your wife, your daughter, your grandchildren? Pray. Pray for them. This is the time to pray. Maybe it's about yourself. There is something you want God to do in your life, in your family. Get ready. Tell of the Lord. Jesus, do not pass me by. Those challenges, those difficulties, Jesus is there, right there with you where you are. Now listening to us, is there with you. Pray, Jesus is coming your way tonight. Christ is coming your way tonight. Jesus is coming your way tonight.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There's no doubt in my mind that tonight, the final night, will be the final knockoff. Every sickness in your body, emancipation. Immediate emancipation. Irreversible emancipation. Interminable emancipation. We're going to pray. Understand, God loves you. God has compassion on you. God is watching. He's been waiting to touch you, and this is your time. You raise up one hand and lay the other hand on yourself. And you will discover, after the final amen, the God that cannot fail, the God of all power, the God of all possibilities, and nothing shall be impossible unto him. And as you believe tonight, it's coming. Raise up that hand and lay the other hand where you have the challenge. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I come on behalf of everyone. Everyone here at the Alpha location, everyone over the radio and before their television and online, everywhere in any country, any nation, oh Lord, descend on them and give them emancipation in Jesus' name. Deliverance for everyone. Healing for everyone. Total. Complete. Cure. Healing. Miracle. Deliverance. The breaking of every yoke. In every life, in Jesus' name. Lord, look at the tears there. Dry up those tears. Take away that suffering. Take away that sickness. From the top of the head to the tip of the toe. I pray, Lord, healing will come to everyone. That spirit of madness, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. That spirit of suicide, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. You are delivered. You are set free. Those who are deaf and dumb, I pray the miracle of hearing and the miracle of speaking, receive it right now in Jesus' name. Those who are blind, Lord, you've done it before. You're doing it again. You're the same yesterday, today, and forever. And if you were physically here, you'll open those blind eyes. And there is no difference. You are the same. I pray blind eyes be touched right now. Be opened right now. Begin to see very well in Jesus' name. The swelling of goiter, hunchback, elephantiasis, hernia, fibroid, any kind of swelling in your body is foreign. It should not be there. I command, come out in Jesus' name. Those who have respiratory problem, asthma, you cannot breathe well, almost getting suffocated, Lord, clear that valve and let them breathe normally, and all the sound, extraneous sound coming as a result of that asthma, heal them in Jesus' name. Cancer, be healed in Jesus' name. Ulcer, be healed in Jesus' name. Tuberculosis, be healed in Jesus' name. HIV/AIDS. Be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, those who have stroke, hand dried up, leg dried up, life. Resurrection life. Healing life. Come on that stroke, rise up and walk in Jesus' name. The lame, paralyzed, or broken bone, whatever your condition, I send forth the healing virtue of the Lord upon you right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. Rise up and walk. Rise up and walk. You've got it. Rise up and walk. Lord, any sickness, any infirmity, pile, whatever, everyone, everywhere now, receive your healing. Receive your miracle. Lord, I pray that the power of heaven, your majesty, your mercy, your miracle will spread everywhere. Right, left, at the back, in front, at the middle, in the Yoruba language, a class there, everywhere, in this nation, in every nation, outside Africa, within Africa, let your power spread everywhere right now. Heal them, deliver them, set them free. Total emancipation. Immediate right now. Confirm it in every life. In Jesus' name I pray. It is done. It is done. There's nothing else you are waiting for. Just check up yourself and you will see the Lord has visited you. Check up, check up. It's there. Demonstrate it. And you'll come to give your testimony.
It is there. You will have your testimony. You already have your testimony. In the name of Jesus. The Lord has touched you tonight. And he has healed you. He has perfected all that concerns you. Congratulations tonight. Check up yourself. You will see what the Lord has done in your life. Thank you everyone for joining us for this program.